It's not always easy to know the rules and policies for handling sensitive information. My team's been developing tools in Office 2016 to help protect information and inform you when sensitive content has been found in your files, and even take an automatic action to help prevent inadvertent data leaks. In the next few minutes, I'll provide an overview of the updates to information protection in Office 2016, including data loss prevention, how to set that up, and what you'll see in Office 2016, securing authentication to Office services with multi-factor authentication, and new ways to securely share your files directly from Outlook. Today, we're rolling out data loss prevention in Office 2016 apps. Let's go ahead and take a look at how that works. Data loss prevention starts with the Office 365 administrator configuring a policy to detect sensitive information. We include a number of different templates to help make it easy for you to get started, but I'm going to go ahead and create a custom rule that looks for credit card information so you can see the experience. So here I've configured a rule that looks for sensitive information. In this case, I'm choosing credit card information. However, we have a wide variety of different built-in types that are available for me to choose from. I'm configuring this rule to detect when that content has been shared externally and to automatically block that content so that only the person that authored the content or owns the content has access to it. So that's how we configure a policy to detect when credit cards have been shared outside my organization. Let's go ahead and switch into Excel and take a look at what the end user experience looks like. So here I'm in Excel and I've inserted some sensitive content into my Excel document. And I can see right in context that Office has detected that the document contains sensitive information, and I can click right here to find out more information about it. Now, this same experience exists whether I'm in Word, PowerPoint, or Excel, so whenever my end users are working on sensitive information, they're notified directly in context about my organization's policies. We've also heard your feedback that you need tighter access controls for services like email. And Office 2016 now supports multi-factor authentication, which usually means that when a user accesses a service, they need to provide a second form of authentication, such as a phone or another passcode. Since we use OAuth standards for establishing secure connections to services, Office 365 allows you to use other security providers. So when I sign into Outlook for the first time and I enter my account details, in this case, my IT administrator has configured my account to request a second form of authentication, in this case from my phone. Once I confirm the information from my phone, Outlook allows me to securely connect to my corporate email. So now that we're in Outlook, one of the most common ways for files to leak outside of an organization is via an email attachment. And in the new Outlook, we can now securely share files directly from Onedrive for Business or SharePoint using the normal attachment flow. So here we can see a number of different documents that I've been working on recently, and I can easily select one of these to share it with Ali. Now, by default, we'll grant Ali permission to edit the document, but from right within my Outlook application, I can go ahead and change those permissions so that she only has permission to view the content. Now, even if she happens to forward this document on to someone else, only Ali has been granted permission to view this content. So you can now easily and securely share content directly from your Outlook. Office 2016 adds new ways to protect information and keep you informed of your organization's policies while you're working. With Office 365, you can get started today by installing the new 2016 apps. I hope you like what you saw today, and thanks for watching the demo bench.